Mantis shrimp are fascinating creatures, both from an ecological and a morphological point of view. They're voracious predators, so their strike, it creates cavitation, which essentially boils the water. And when that bubble collapses, it creates a shockwave that can stun their prey. People ask me a lot whether or not they're capable of breaking glass, because that's one of the myths about them, but they are actually capable of breaking glass. Disco clams live on coral reefs. They're bright red, they have long tentacles, and they flash light. So the flashing actually occurs at the mantle edge of the clam, and it looks like lightning is going back and forth. When the mantis shrimp was interacting with the clam, punching it essentially to try to break it open, the disco clam actually opened up to expose all of that soft tissue and began flashing, which is not what you would typically think would occur in the middle of an attack. The mantis shrimp went into this sort of catatonic state for up to 15 minutes. They really seemed to dislike the interaction with that tissue, which gave us the idea that there could be something in this tissue that's distasteful or noxious, and that the bright coloration and the flashing was a sort of aposematic or warning signal. So what we did was we gave them a choice stick with the white internal adductor muscle, which is the muscle that actually keeps the clam closed, and this bright red external tissue. We found that they loved eating the internal white colored tissue, and they really did not like eating the external red tissue. So we know that there's this chemical distinction. The first reason it's exciting is that both of these animals are incredibly unique. Their interaction on the reef as a predator-prey relationship is quite dynamic. The role of potential aposematism, the evolution of flashing in an Indo-Pacific species versus a Caribbean species. There are just a lot of different components that I think make the relationship between the two very interesting.